जायो जायो प्रभुपाद 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 जायो जायो प्रभुपाद
ओम नमो भगवते
Reading from the Bhagavad Gita as it is, the chapter number 9, the most confidential knowledge, text number 32. Chapter 9, text number 32. It's on page 497 in my book. Mamhi Partha Vaya Pashtya
Mamhi Partha Pashtya
Yepishu Papayonaya
Yepishu Papayonaya
Striyo Vaishyastata Sudras
Triyo Vaishyastata Sudras
Tepiyanti Parangatim
Tepiyanti Parangatim
Mamhi Partha Vaya Pashtya
Mamhi Partha Vaya Pashtya
Yepishu papayonaya
Yepishu papayonaya
Sriyo vaishyastata sutras
Sriyo vaishyastata sutras
Yepiyanti parangati
Yepiyanti parangati
Mamni bhakta vaya pashritya
Mamni bhakta vaya pashritya
Yepishu papayonaya
Yepishu papayonaya
Sriyo Vaishyastata Sutras
Sriyo Vaishyastata Sutras
Deti Yanti Parangatim
Deti Yanti Parangatim Mamhi Partha Vyapasritya
Mamhi Partha Vyapasritya
Ye Api Shu Papayonaya
Deti Yanti Parangatim
Sriyo Vaishyastata Sutras
Sriyo Vaishyastata
Sutras Te Api Yanti ते अपि यन्ति परं गतिं मां हि पार्था व्यपाश्रित्य येपिषु पापयोनया श्रियो वैशासता
शुद्रा
Epi Yanti Parangatim
Mami Partha Vyapasritya
Mami Partha Sripya
Yakshu Papiyonam
Yepi Paju Papayonaya
Istriyam Vesta Yatta
Sityam Vaishya Tata Sutra
Istriyam Yanti Paramgatam
Yepi Yanti Paramgati
Mamki
Pata Yapasritya
Sriyo
Vaishyastata Sutras
Epi Yanti Paramgatim
Mam
of me
he
certainly
Partha
Osamaprita
Vaya Pashritya Particularly taking shelter.
Ye.
Those who.
Api.
Also.
Shu.
I.
Papayonaya.
Born of lower family. Striya.
Women.
Vaishya,
mercantile people,
Tata,
also,
Sudra,
lower class men,
Te Abhi,
even they,
Yanti,
go,
Param,
to the Supreme,
Gatim,
destination.
Translation. O son of Prita, those who take shelter of me, though they be of lower birth, women, Vaishyas, merchants, and Sudras, workers, can attain the supreme destination.
Rudavi Magani, Pengal, Vaishyargal, Sutrangal, Yena. கீழ்குலத்தை சேர்ந்தவர்கள் யாராலும் இருந்தாலும் என்னிடம் சரணடைந்தவர்கள் பரமகதியை அடைய முடியும்.
It is clearly declared here by the Supreme Lord that in devotional service there is no distinction between the lower and higher classes of people. In the material conception of life, there are such divisions, but for a person engaged in transcendental devotional service to the Lord, there are not. Everyone is eligible for the supreme destination. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is stated that even the lowest, who are called Chandalas or dog eaters, can be purified by association with a pure devotee. Therefore, devotional service and the guidance of a pure devotee are so strong that there is no discrimination between the lower and higher classes of men. Anyone can take to it. The most simple man taking shelter of the pure devotee can be purified by proper guidance. According to the different modes of material nature, men are classified in the mode of goodness, brahmanas, the mode of passion, kshatriyas, or administrators, the mixed modes of passion and ignorance, Vaishyas or merchants, and the mode of ignorant sudras or workers. Those lower than them are called chandalas, and they are born in sinful families. Generally, the association of those born in sinful families
is not acceptable by the higher classes. But the process of devotional service is so strong that the pure devotee of the Supreme Lord can enable people of all the lower classes to attain the highest perfection of life. This is possible only when one takes shelter of Krishna, as indicated here by the word Vayapashritya. One has to take shelter completely of Krishna. Then one can become much greater than great gyanis and yogis.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
குருளுடைய ஸ்ரீ பக்திவேதாந்த சுவாமி ஸ்ரீ பிரபுபாதி பக்தி தொண்டில் உயர்ந்த தாழ்ந்த வகுப்பை சேர்ந்த மக்களிடையே எவ்வித வேறுபாடும் இல்லை என்பதை இங்கு தெளிவாக பரம புருஷரால் அறிவிக்கப்படுகின்றது. வாழ்வின் ஜன பார்வையில் இத்தகைய வேறுபாடுகள் உண்டு, ஆனால் பகவானின் திவ்யமான அன்பு தொண்டில் ஈடுபட்டிருப்பவர்களுக்கு இவை கிடையாது. எல்லோரும் பரமகதியை உன்னத இலக்கு அடைய தகுதியுடையவர்களாகிறார்கள். ஸ்ரீமத் பாகவதத்தில் 2.4.18 தூய பக்தியுடைய தொடர்பால் தாழ்ந்தவர்களான சண்டாளர்களும் நாய உண்பவர்களும் தூய்மையடைய முடியும் என்று கூறப்பட்டுள்ளது. எனவே உயர்ந்த தாழ்ந்த இனத்தை சேர்ந்த மனிதர்களும் முன்னேறுவதற்கு தூய பக்தியின் வழிகாட்டுவதால் பக்தி தோன்றும் வலிமை வாய்ந்தவை. எல்லோரும் இத்தகைய பயிற்சி செய்யலாம். தூய பக்தியுடன் தஞ்சமடையும் சாதாரணமான மனிதனாகவும் தகுந்த வழிகாட்டின் கீழ் தூய்மையடைய முடியும். பௌதீக இயற்கையின் பல்வேறு குணங்களுக்கு ஏற்றவாறு மனிதர்கள் பிரிக்கப்படுகின்றனர். சாத்வ குணத்தை சேர்ந்தவர்கள் பிராமணர்கள், ராஜச குணத்தை சேர்ந்தவர்கள் சத்திரியர்கள், ரஜோகுணம் தாமகுணம் கலந்தவர்கள் வைஷ்யர்கள் மற்றும் தாமகுணத்தை சேர்ந்தவர்கள் சூத்திரர்கள். இதற்கிடையில் கீழ்நிலையில் உள்ளவர்கள் சண்டாளர்கள் என்று அழைக்கப்படுகின்றனர். அவர்கள் பல பாவப்பட்ட குடும்பத்தில் பிறந்தவர்கள். பொதுவாக பாவப்பட்ட குடும்பத்தில் பிறப்பவர்களின் உறவினை உயர்ந்த வகுப்பையினர் என்று அழைப்பதில்லை. ஆனால் பக்தி தொண்டில் மிகவும் வலிமையானவதாகவும் பரம புருஷரின் தூய பக்தர் இந்த வகுப்பை சேர்ந்த எல்லா மக்களும் வாழ்வில் மிக உயர்ந்த பக்குவத்தை அளிக்க முடியும். கிருஷ்ணரிடம் தஞ்சமடைகின்ற பொழுது மட்டுமே இது சாத்தியமாகும். என்னும் சொல்லால் குறிப்பிடப்பட்டுள்ளது போல் கிருஷ்ணரிடம் முழுமையாக சரணடைய வேண்டும். பின்னால் அவர் சிறந்த ஞானிகளாலும் யோகிகளாலும் இடையே மிகவும் சிறந்தவர்களாக ஆகலாம்.
வந்தேராம் ஸ்ரீ குரு ஸ்ரீ யுக்தாம் பரம் கமலம் ஸ்ரீ குரு
Krishna is describing that our birth in this material world is not an obstacle to us coming to the
perfection.
Some people may think, I'm a Brahmin. So Brahmin, you think that's the topmost birth in the world. So we think the Brahmin is sure to go back to Godhead, but it's not true. One may be Brahmana by birth, but you may be very proud, and if he's proud, then you will not get the supreme destination. But Krishna said, Krishna recognizes that there are higher and lower birth by the material standards. So, low birth means to be born outside the very culture. Like me, I'm a Chandala. By birth. I'm born in the Western country. So I'm outside the Vedic culture. But in the Kali Yuga, there's no real Vedic, there's no Vedic culture, there's no Brahmanas. In the Kali Yuga, everyone is a Sudra or Lord. We're Sudra or Lord because people don't follow the Vedic culture. And we see that low birth is not only to be born outside the Vedic culture, but even you may be born somewhere in the Vedic culture, you may be a Vaishya, or you may be a Sudra. So Vaishya, businessmen and Sudras, the workers, the laborers, in the Kali Yuga, most people are Vaishyas and Sudras. We don't see any real Brahmanas, and there's no Kshatriyas also. Although people may claim by birthright that no, we're Kshatri and we're Brahman, but actually, it's just a name only. It's not really true. You don't have the qualities of these castes. And women, of course, women's body is also considered lower than the man. By the Vedic culture, the women, they would just simply be at home. They wouldn't have to go to work. They would be married women and they'd take care of their family and children. But you see the society today, all the women are working. They all have jobs, they go to work. Even they're married, they have children, they go to work.
Now,
people feel very difficult to maintain if only one person is earning, the money is not enough. So women are working just like the men, and there's propaganda made that women are equal to men. And in some places, some people, they say women are better than the men. So, we can say, well, women, they're also doing all the things the men are doing. But often the money they're paid is not as much as the men. Although they may do the same job, they're not getting the same pay. What they pay for the pay the man, they won't pay that same amount to the woman. And so of course there's a lot of discrimination against people these days, and some governments, like in India, they're trying to fight against that kind of discrimination. So Lord Krishna says, actually, doesn't matter what your birth is, spiritually, you're all equal. The body is different, but the soul is the same. Cannot say I'm a male soul or she's a female soul. No, the soul is not male or female. So we have to come off from the bodily concept of life. The Lord Krishna said everyone can attain the supreme destination if they take shelter of Him. So how to take shelter of Lord Krishna? That is explained in the purport by Srila Prabhupada. You have to take shelter of the devotee of Krishna, a pure devotee. The pure devotee can bring us to Krishna by His mercy. We need the mercy of the devotee to connect to Krishna. We cannot just go to Krishna directly. And just like if we want to go and see the Prime Minister, I want to see this Mr. Anwar, is it? Yes? Right? I am from Malacca, I'm from the Hare Krishna temple, and I want to see Anwar. I want to see him and talk to him. But we won't get to meet the Prime Minister. He's an important man, he's a busy man. But if you know his secretary, then secretary he could arrange. By the help of the secretary, you can arrange the appointment and you can go and meet them. So in the same way, you want to meet Lord Krishna, If you just go directly, Lord Krishna won't, you know, he won't be interested so much because we don't have the introduction. Just like if you want to go to Vaikuntha to meet Lord Narayan, you have to go through the doors to get into Vaikuntha. So even the four Kumaras, who were the sons of Lord Brahma, they went to Vaikuntha and they got stopped at the door by the gatekeepers. You know, Jai and Vijay are there, they're the doorkeepers, and they stop the four Kumaras and say, why are you coming here, you're not qualified. They didn't have the introduction from the pure devotee. And so it's very important to get the mercy of the devotee in order to get the mercy of Krishna. Prabhupada Maharaj was asked by his father, where did you get your devotion from? Because Prahlad's father had sent him to the school for the demons. He wanted his son to be a good demon. But Prahlad had become a great devotee and he was preaching to his father that, you know, you should become a devotee. Don't be envious, don't make enemies with people, see everybody equally, be friendly with everyone. But the last father, he hated Vishnu. And he wanted to kill Vishnu. And when his son was preaching to Prahlad, was telling his father that you should take shelter of Lord Vishnu, the Hiranyakashipu got very angry. Prahlad was sitting on his lap, and Hiranyakashipu threw him off his lap. He said, what? Vishnu? What? You asked me to give up to worship Vishnu? Who taught you all this? So Prahlad Maharaj told his father, there's only one way you get Krishna conscious. You have to get the mercy of a devotee. You want to get bhakti, you have to get it from someone who has bhakti. You can't just get bhakti just by doing things. You have to get the mercy from a devotee. So we say every day, we say by the mercy of the devotee, we get the mercy of Krishna. And without the mercy, then you'll never get the mercy of Krishna. So Lord Krishna is saying, even somebody, doesn't matter what their birth is, they can get the supreme destination.
The Bhagavad Sukrishna Sukhina Aga Inda Chunani Inja
But they have to take shelter. They have to take shelter of Krishna by taking shelter of Krishna's devotee. The devotees of Krishna, they know how to come to Krishna.
Krishna
So we have to get the mercy through the devotee. So that mercy comes, sometimes comes in the form of the beach, the sea, the bhakti lata beach. You meet the devotee and the devotee puts the seed of devotion or gives you that seed, it nourishes, energizes the seed of devotion. And then once that seed is there, we have to take care of it.
We
have to watch out the seed. And you have to pull out the weeds. You have to take care that the seed will grow to a nice plant and it will grow up and up. And actually we want that plant to grow all the way up to the spiritual world. And it should produce flowers, and then there should be fruits. And the fruit is Krishna
Prema.
We want to produce the fruit of Krishna Prema. So, to get that Krishna Prema, to get that love for Krishna, we have to cultivate the plant very carefully. Now somebody may have a good birth. What, you know, where Krishna is talking about people of low birth. What if someone has a good birth? Someone may say, I have a good birth. I'm born in the Brahmana family. Do I still need to take the mercy of the Guru and to have a pure devotee's mercy? Yes, everybody has to. And even you're born in the Brahmana family, it doesn't matter. Because by birth, you're not really Brahman. You may say you're Brahman, but actually, Kali Yuga, nobody's really
Brahman.
And even if you are a Brahman, still you still have to be, have the mercy of a devotee. Krishna will only recognize the person who has faith in his devotees. Lord Krishna went to see the one Brahmin, Shukadeva. He was living in the city of Mithila. Mithila. Shrutadeva was a humble Brahmin. He lived just very simple, poor life. He didn't have anything. Somehow, whatever he needed, it was provided by the grace of God.
Shrutadeva,
So one day, Lord Krishna came from Dwarka and he brought all the great sages with him to visit Shrutadev. So Lord, this Brahmana Shrutadev, he was very happy. Lord Krishna was coming to his home and he didn't have anything really much to receive him. He just got some straw and some grass, put it on the ground and asked the sages and Lord Krishna to sit there. And he honored the Lord Krishna and the great sages. He washed their feet, he sprinkled the water on the head of his family and everybody. And then Shrutadeva also glorified Lord Krishna. So then Lord Krishna, he glorified the sages. He told Shrutadeva that don't just glorify me, he said these sages are even greater than me. So these sages, they were glorified by Lord Krishna, and Shrutadeva was telling, Lord Krishna was telling Shrutadeva that you have to recognize these sages, that they are myself, they represent my teachings. He said, you may worship the deity, and you may touch the deity, and you get purified. Or you may go to holy places and bathe in the holy rivers and get purified. But the sages, just by looking at you, they can purify you. They will purify you even more than what you get from the holy places. The holy places purify very slowly. Just like if you bathe in Ganga, you have to bathe many, 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 many times to get purified. But the pure devotee, if he just looks on you one time, he can deliver you very quickly. So in this way, we have to understand the importance of getting the mercy of the devotees. So who is the pure devotee? Well, everyone who is chanting Hare Krishna and following the principles. Krishna consciousness movement is a society for pure devotees. You follow the four principles, you chant Hare Krishna. That is a pure devotee, not doing anything sinful. So we have to take the advantage of the association with the devotee. Yes? Question? So we can change the karma, get rid of the karma by devotional service. We have to do devotional service. You have to hear and chant. That way you purify the consciousness. So, devotional service is so powerful. It changes, burns up all the karma. There's different stages, different phases of karma. Some karma we're suffering from at the present moment. Just like, you know, maybe you're not healthy, so that's bad karma. So we all have some karma. We have some good and some bad karma. And that's there in the body. But there's karma which is also coming, which is not there in the body yet, but it's subtle, it's going to come in the future. We say prakat and aprakat. So prakat, you can see the karma. And aprakat, it's not manifest yet, but it's going to become. So bhakti yoga is so powerful that it gets rid of all that karma. But you have to do the bhakti yoga sincerely. You have to really want to develop devotion for Krishna. We have to want to surrender. So, devotional service is it like a fire. It can burn all the wood to ashes. So the wood is like our karma, all burnt to ashes. And because we have a lot of material desires, these material desires, they're like snakes. Yeah. So when there's a fire in the forest, all the snakes are burned. But other animals the snakes of desire are all burdened by the devotional Krishna said, if you surrender to me, I will free you from all sinful reactions. So we're all born with karma, but karma, there's karma, vikarma, and akarma. So karma means to do activities according to the Vedas.
Karma tara hai mool bagar dekha hai karma, vikarma, and akarma.
Just like you want to get some material things, you have some material desires, you may go to the temple, you do some ritual, you do some karma kandi activity, you worship some god or something, you go to the nine planets and worship the planets, try to get your desires fulfilled. So that's karmic activity, acting according to the Vedas. But when you do things against the Vedas, that's called vikarma. Right? You do things against the Vedas, you do some sinful things, intoxication, meat eating, gambling, these things, then you get bad karma for that. Causes us to suffer. Karmic activities, they bring material enjoyment. And vikarmic activities, they bring suffering. But if you do bhakti yoga, it is akarma. Just like the food we eat here, it is called prasada. It is karma free. There's no karma in the food because it's offered to Krishna. And when you eat the food which is offered to Krishna, you don't get any karma. But other food which is not offered to Krishna, which is, then you get karma. Even if it's vegetarian food, it may be vegetarian food, but still you get some karma. Of course, if it's non-vegetarian food, then you get more karma. But if it's offered to Krishna, there is no karma. It purifies us. Takes away the karma. So we encourage you in food offered to Krishna. And to offer to Krishna, it must be vegetarian. Krishna is a vegetarian. No meat, fish, and egg. No onion, no garlic. All right. Any other question?
Thank you. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
What is the topmost preaching by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Well, the topmost preaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Sankirtan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a Yuga avatar, and he came to inaugurate the Yuga Dharma. Kali Yuga Dharma, Harinam Sankirtan. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to inaugurate the chanting of the holy name for everyone. Because before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, there was chanting of the holy name, but it was only in the temple, and it was only by the Brahmanas. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave the holy name to everyone. Krishna, Shri Prabhupada ki
jai,
Bhagavad Gita ki
jai.